Hello again, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Woodpeckers Deep Dive. My name is Jeff Farris. Welcome to my shop. Today, we're going to take a closer look at how you go about building chairs and stools and the geometry involved and how to get away from the geometry. Then we're going to take a look at drilling those angled holes using Woodpecker's new Duax angle drilling table. All right, let's get started. So when you're building a chair or a stool, the compound angle on the leg, basically there are four terms that you need to become familiar with. Rake, splay, resultant angle, and sight angle. Let's go over each one. Rake and splay are the angles that the leg is leaving the seat at. You can see this is going this way, all right? If this is the front of the chair, let's say it's a chair instead of a stool. This one's symmetrical, makes it a lot easier, all right? But if it's in a chair, very often the front legs and the back legs don't have the same angle. The angle from the front of the chair this way is the splay. And the angle from the front of the chair to the back of the chair, this angle is called the rake. All right, now in some chair designs, the back legs will have a different rake and splay than the front legs. That's why I like to make stools. They're usually symmetrical and it makes the whole thing a lot simpler. So that explains splay and rake. Now the next one we need to take a look at is the sightline angle. Now the sightline angle is the point where, as I turn this for the camera, there's going to be a point where it looks like this leg is straight up and down, doesn't have any angle at all. That is the sightline. Now, on a symmetrical stool, that's really simple because the sightline angle is 45 degrees. On a chair where you have different angles, there's some math to do. We're going to talk about that in a little bit. But on a symmetrical stool, you're always dealing with a 45 degree sight line. Last one is the resultant angle. Now, when you are looking at the sight line, if I'm looking at the opposite sight line, 90 degrees to where you are, this is not two angles, it's one. And that resultant angle is really the only one we're worried about when we're drilling our seat top. So what we're going to take a look at here is the layout on the underside of our seat. As I said, our sightline angle is 45 degrees, so I've drawn a diagonal on this, 45 both directions. And then I have come in 2 inches from the edge on all four corners. So that is our drilling point for each one of our stool legs. And when we're lining up, we're going to be sure that we're right on our sight line. So now let's talk about that resultant angle. This gets into a little bit of trigonometry, but we have equal rake and splay angles at 6 degrees in both directions. And I have a handy little chart here that I want to tell you about. And if I go to my chart and I find a rake angle of 6 degrees and a splay angle of 6 degrees, we find out that the resultant angle is 8.5 degrees. That's the one that we want to use when we get ready to drill our seat. So while I was working on trying to figure out all of the math involved in doing chairs and stools, I ran across a website. It's a blog by a fellow named Matt McGrain. And Matt is a guy that has a degree in both mathematics and statistics. He worked in the medical devices industry for many, many years. He's retired now, and he works almost exclusively with hand tools. Really, really interesting blog. And one of his blog entries is all about the trigonometry involved in chairs and stools. And he developed this spreadsheet, which you can download. There's a link down below in the description that will take you right to Matt's blog where you can download the spreadsheet. And I want to show you a really nifty feature on here. Down here at the bottom of the spreadsheet, there is a table. So I had really, really simple math, right? We had 6-degree rake, 6-degree splay, comes out to 8.5 resultant angle. You're not always going to be that lucky. Sometimes you have oddball angles or half degrees. Well, at the bottom of this, you can actually plug in the rake angle and the splay angle, and it will automatically compute for you the resultant angle and the sight line and give it to you in a matter of seconds. Same thing with the height of the seat off of the ground. If you tell it how high you want the seat, it will tell you how long to make the legs based on the angle that you've used. It's really brilliant. If you've ever wanted to make a chair or a stool, this is the spreadsheet you want to download. Now, one of the things I really like about the Duax is I can do all of the critical setup here at the workbench and then just take it over the drill press, mount it up, and we're ready to go. The first thing that we need to adjust is we need to set the resultant angle, 8.5 degrees, on our protractor right here. We're going to adjust that until the cursor is right between 8 and 9. The resultant angle is set. The next thing we need to do is set the fence on the Duax to the sightline angle of 45 degrees. Now, I need that to be on the high side of the table so that my seat is going downhill. So that means I need to turn my fence around, which is really simple. We just slip it off, and now we're going to slip it back on facing the other direction. Now, when I'm on this side, my scale is not going to be very helpful. So what I'm going to do is take a delve square and use that to set my 45 degrees. Now, I've got this set up so it's pretty far back on my sacrificial block, because when we drill this, we're going to be drilling right about here, and that's where the biggest amount of support is, and also I'm not going to run into my table coming off this low edge. So that's why I've got that fence pretty far up on my sacrificial block. The 45 degree angle is set. Now we need to give it a reference point. So I'm going to put my flip stop in here. And now this is going to be my reference point, and I want to work with this relatively close to the center of my table. Now we've got everything located so that the pressure is directly over the protractor. Now we're going to take it over and mount it to the drill press. So I have the Duax mounted to my drill press table. The drill press table is loose on the column so that it can rotate sideways. And the Duax is loose in the tracks so that it can move this way. So all I need to do now is put my seat on here, clamp it down, and locate it right underneath the drill bit. Now, I'm using a smaller drill bit that I'm actually going to drill with. I have a real tiny brad point here that has a very, very fine point. That's going to make sure I get it lined up just right. Now, when I get that close, I'll lock my table first. We'll lock everything down. Put on my crosshairs. Now I'll double check my clamping position, make sure that is secure. Now that we have it dialed in, I'm going to change from my brad point bit to the 1-inch Forstner bit that I'll be drilling with, and we'll be ready to go. All the hard work is in the first one. For the other three holes, we should be able to just bring the stock against the fence and the stop. We'll be perfectly aligned and we'll drill the other three holes. So we've got our seat drilled, and there's a couple of different ways to proceed from this point. One of the things that we can do is turn the leg. But with a turn leg, when you've got two problems. One is that you have to turn the tenon just right. It has to fit snugly in the hole to be sure that you get a good glue joint. The other issue is you'll see that because this is going out at an angle, there's a bigger gap on the inside than there is on the outside. Now, some turners do a very, very nice job of cutting that tapered transition, but it's still perpendicular to the axis of the leg going into an angular hole. It's never going to match up perfect. Here's a trick that I've been using lately on a couple of different stools that I've done. I'm taking my leg and I'm drilling a hole dead straight into the end of that. Then I cut my taper after I drill the hole. So it's much easier drilling, especially with the Duax. You can clamp that vertically, drill straight into the end of the leg. Now, when we put our 6 and 6 taper on there, we put a dowel into that, and it just drops right into place. We drop that in, and we get a perfect match between our 6-degree rake and the bottom of our seat. So we've got the leg assembly ready to go. There'll be one more step, and that is to go back to the drill press with the Duax and cut the 6-degree angle for the stretcher. We'll do that on another episode of Deep Dive somewhere down the road. Hey folks, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Deep Dive. If you did, be sure and give us a thumbs up. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. That way you'll know about every one of our great videos right when they come out. Thanks for watching today. We'll see you next time on Deep Dive.